Welcome back. From devastating droughts to relentless rain, our farmers have been bearing Mother Nature's brutal force for years now. Thankfully, help is on the way in the form of a new government grant, but there's a catch.
Dairy farmer Max Wake and his son Gavin join us now from Singleton in New South Wales. Look, thanks for joining us this morning. Max, last Thursday, I know your farm was deep under floodwaters. It's the fourth flood this year.
Whoa.
I mean, how do you keep getting up?
Well, it makes it very hard. I'm afraid when you're on the land, you've just got to do what you've got to do. And quite honestly, I think a flood is probably worse than a drought. You can manage a drought, you can't manage a flood. And it's just one of those facts of life. And it makes, when you've got, you know, 270 cows that you've got to feed every day and milk twice a day and try and find somewhere for them when your whole farm's underwater, it makes it very, very difficult.
How do you get through it, especially given the damage, Bill?
Well, Carl, I guess we've done it before, and I suppose it comes as an instinct to us. But you just can't get away from the fact that it's very difficult. It's very costly. The other sidekick to it is that we have a lot of cows with mastitis at the moment because of the mud. The poor cows are laying in mud. They've got nowhere dry to lie down, and of course they get mastitis. We've probably got 12 or 13 cows out of the vat with mastitis, which is a cost, and then you've got the cost of treating them as well. And it just goes from one to the other, and we've had to shift a lot of cattle and got them away on adjustment and things like that.
That's
expensive. So tell you what, if it's not one thing, it's the other, isn't it? Hey, Gav, just for you, I mean, for this to have been your fourth flood you've experienced in a year, have you ever seen anything like this in your time on the land?
No, well, I guess I was only thinking about it last night. I'm 42 years old. I've experienced six moderate or major floods here. I've got a four-year-old son and he's experienced five. So, yeah, it's... We can handle floods. We live on floodplain. We know it's going to flood. That's why we farm here, because it's some of the best land in the country. But you can survive a flood. You can't survive five in 18 months. It just makes it so hard. We always subscribe to the theory that, you know, we look after the cows will look after us. And at the moment, we feel like we're the ones letting them down because we can't look after them as best we can, and that makes it hard.
Very. And look, there are government grants around, and I know that one of them particularly involves $75,000, a joint grant between federal and state government. You have to spend the money first in order to get the money back. How does that sit with you? Is there a better way here?
Oh, look, any assistance is good assistance, but in a normal time, if we had a flood, that system would work. But the fact that this is now essentially our fifth event, the first one wasn't a major flood, but we've had our farm go under five times in 18 months. And like I said, any assistance is good assistance, but you've got to spend that money before you can get it back. And the first once or twice, that's fine. You can do that, but After five, it makes it really hard. You know, we were only commenting before this event that 2 days before this last event, our farm was back being full production again. Look, we had all our paddocks back in full production after the March event for 2 days, and now we're back to square one again. So it makes it very, very hard to stay in front when your cash flow is so negatively impacted for a long period of time.
Well, I mean, that's it, isn't it? You can't spend the money if you don't have it there. How do you both feel about, or Max, I'll ask you, how do you feel about the fact we're being told there's more rain on the way?
Yeah, well, it makes you very, very nervous. Like, we've been informed that there's probably going to be an East Coast low form again next week, and I'm very fidgety about it. If we get another flood, and it won't take very much rain to make a flood, because everything is just absolutely saturated. The water's just oozing out of the ground. And I guess we can do nothing except wait and see. But gee whiz, if we get another flood now, that's going to be absolutely devastating. even though the others were devastating enough, this will be even worse. But it hasn't happened yet. Let's hope it doesn't.
You guys are not alone. There are plenty, you know, this is the wrong time of year for them to get this much rain as well. I appreciate your time today. Also, there's other issues like foot and mouth that's lurking now in Bali. I mean, there are biosecurity issues left, right and centre across this part of the world right now. So our farmers are facing an awful lot just because it's raining.